Hey, what's up everyone? It's Eric here from Guy and Cakes bringing you another video. And before I start, I just want to thank everyone who has subscribed to my channel. I'm over 100 subscribers, so I'm very, very excited about that. It's not a huge, huge number, but still it means a whole lot to me. And I just appreciate your support. I cannot, you know, get to that number without you. So thank you so much. And let's jump into it. We got work to do. Let's go. All right, guys. So today's video is on the Yeezy 350 V2 Carbon. Alright guys, so the Yeezy 350 V2 Carbon released on October 2nd, 2020 for a retail price of $220. I don't know if you all heard, but this shoe had a little bit of controversy with the religious name that was going to be used by Yeezy and Adidas, and the name was scratched and they used the Carbon name. As you can see here on the box, it still has the Azrael name. I guess it was a decision that was relatively late and they decided to remove the Azrael name and go with the Carbon name. But this is a 350, so it's pretty much similar to the previous 350s that we've seen in the past. Upper here is primarily a prime knit material. It's pretty much the same prime knit pattern as like the Yeezy 350 and the black colorway. Starting with the inside of the shoe around the Achilles heel, you're gonna find the 3M three stripes. Behind the tongue area, you're gonna find a little bit of a soft material there for comfort. On this particular pair, it has the Infinity Lace system as we've seen in previous 350s, 380s, and V3s. Similar to other Yeezys, the color palette on this pair is not super easy to describe, but the majority of the colors here are basically a black, sort of bluish purple color, and some light grays. Moving to the lateral side of the shoe, you're gonna find the translucent stripe made out of a mesh material. As you come over to the heel part of the shoe, this particular pair does not have a heel tab. Colors on the lateral side, I would say they're more on the lighter side of the color palette than compared to the medial side. Around the lateral side, around the top of the upper of the shoe, the colors there tend to be a little bit more purple. And then on the medial side, the colors there tend to be more of a darker blue and more of that black color. The midsole on this particular pair has a cream color, and then on the outsole has a lighter gum color. And like all 350s, it has a full length boost. This Yeezy also comes with another pair of laces if you wanna go and switch it back to that traditional look. Just keep in mind, like I've said before, with this pull lace system, you have to actually cut the laces in order to replace it with the traditional look. So once you cut them, then that's it. You can't go back to this look. All right, guys. So in terms of my opinion on the shoe, there's a couple of things that I like and a couple of things I don't like. I mean, it's a 350 overall, so I'm a fan of the 350 silhouette in general. So there's not much dislike there. But if I'm gonna just sort of nitpick a couple of things, I'm just gonna point out that, you know, I'm not a huge fan of the 350s without the pull tab. I feel like when the ones that don't have it, you obviously can tell that there's something missing. But I am a fan of the pull tab. I know some of you are a fan of this look. It looks cleaner, looks sleeker, but I do like the pull tab on the 350s. I don't mind the cream midsole and the little bit of the gum bottom here, but honestly, I think if they would have gone with the same, you know, black color of the upper of the shoe, I think the shoe would have looked a lot cleaner. And I think most people would have liked it a little bit more. So I would have replaced that with the black color. I don't know if that's more of a cost thing, that it's more expensive to actually have the midsole and outsole painted black. I'm not sure, but I would have gone with that color instead of this cream color. And lastly, in terms of things I don't like, I'm still not a huge fan of the Infinity Lace system. I think I still like the traditional look. Obviously, I know it comes with the extra pair. I think it would be cool to go with the traditional look, make the laces 3M, give it a little bit more pop instead of going with the Infinity Lace system. But it's like one of those, it's just me nitpicking that, to be honest, because obviously, having the lace system, you have the option. Do you want to stick with this look or you want to go with the traditional look? And in terms of things that I do like, there's more things that I like about this shoe that I don't like. Honestly, I think this shoe overall, this colorway is my favorite 350 colorway of 2020. I think this colorway is one of those that if this colorway would have came out years ago, it would have been a super, super hype shoe. But being that, you know, we're in 2020 now, we get 350s like every other month, which is cool. I think that's why this shoe doesn't have that same buzz. But in terms of recent 350s in general, I think this is one of my favorite ones. So I definitely like this colorway a lot. I like that in this colorway, you can see, you know, the different tones of the colors. Like I said, you know, you have one side that's a little lighter, you know, has more of the those purplish blue colors. And on the other side, you have more of those darker colors. So I do like that a lot, that you can actually tell. You don't actually have to have the shoe up close to be able to notice that. And in general, it's a Yeezy 350 V2, and you can't go wrong with this pair. If you've never gotten a pair of Yeezy 350s and you're looking for, you know, a darker color, maybe this is one to go for. I also like that this color goes well with the season. We're in fall now, so that definitely, you know, with the darker colors, you know, fits well with your outfits and things like that. So that's something to consider if you're looking into buying a Yeezy 350. And finally, in terms of sizing, just like any other Yeezy 350, I always go true to size in these. I've said this before, if you can't find your actual size in the 350s, go a half size up. Or if you do find, you know, your actual size and they're a little bit tight, you can always remove the insole to make them feel better and a little bit more comfortable. All right guys, so let me show you how they look on feet. Alright guys, so I hope this video was able to give you a detailed look of the Yeezy 350 V2 Carbon. Like always, thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much for those who have subscribed. For those that are new to the channel, welcome. Please feel free to subscribe, hit the notification button so you don't miss any of my videos. Help me grow this channel so I can bring you guys more content and more information. And like always, follow me on Instagram at Guy and Kicks. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. See ya.